Welcome back to Big Movie Mouth Off. We're here at Groovy Cinema Pub reviewing more movies. I'm Jeff Weiss with MSN Entertainment.
And I'm Jimmy Martin with Slug Magazine.
Our next movie is Ruby Sparks, a comedy fantasy about a writer's blocked, once famous novelist, played by Paul Dano from Little Miss Sunshine, who, as a writing exercise, writes a story about his dream girlfriend, and is then shocked when it turns out she has either come to life or she's a real person. By the way, she's played by Zoe Kazan, a young, up-and-coming character actress, the, I believe, granddaughter of filmmaker Elia Kazan. She wrote the screenplay.
Fancies.
Yeah, by the way, she and Paul Dano are a couple in real life, which I think had a lot to do with the casting of both of them in the roles, obviously, and they have chemistry.
Why do you think you're not writing?
I don't know. I get a good idea, and then, bam, I start thinking that is the stupidest thing ever.
Tell me about it.
Ruby Sparks, 26 years old, raised in Dayton, Ohio.
Why Dayton?
Sounds romantic. Ruby got kicked out of high school for sleeping with her art teacher, or maybe her Spanish teacher. I haven't decided yet.
I'm glad you found something that inspires you.
Inspires me. It's like I'm falling in love with her.
That's wonderful.
I can't fall in love with the girl I write.
Why not?
Because she's not real.
I missed you in bed last night. Did you get some good writing done?
Calvin, are you mad at me?
Remember how Dad used to say I had an overactive imagination?
That's good.
Calvin, but there's no possible way that Ruby's in your house because she's not a real person.
Can you see her?
Calvin!
She's real.
Ruby!
What is going on with you?
I don't know. I'm sorry.
Kiss me, stupid.
There's got to be some logical explanation.
People don't appear out of thin air.
She did.
How?
I don't know how. It's love. It's magic.
Have you tried writing more? Write something about her and see if it comes true. If it does, this is a miracle.
Insane! You manifested a woman with your mind.
You can make her do anything you want.
For men everywhere, tell me you're not gonna let that go to waste.
I'm not the biggest Paul Dano fan in the world.
I
understand why he's in the film because this is an edgy character. I just wish he were more initially likable.
See, I think he's likable in the sense, he's not your typical actor.
Right.
Because he's got this weird, socially awkward vibe to him. But I think it works in this role because he is this, you know, one-time New York Times bestseller who hasn't written a book in like 10 years and doesn't know what he's doing with his life. But people still, and I love it, they always call him a genius throughout the film, and it really makes him uncomfortable because he's just like, I haven't done anything in a decade. You know, why am I, if I'm such a genius, then what the hell is wrong with me? But he's got this quirky vibe to him. And what makes it even better is that this spunky, you know, girl of his dreams is now in his possession, and he still has no idea what to do, you know? But where I do like it is because, and you mentioned the chemistry, I'm glad you did, because it kind of reminded me of The Amazing Spider-Man with Andrew Garfield and Emma Stone, and sometimes it works. If you have chemistry on and off screen, you can capture it, and it makes it even better. Which I think the chemistry in this film was really well done, and, but the where I have a lot of fun with this, I almost call it like an independent version of Weird Science, where these guys get this dream girl and have no idea what to do with her. But it's when he starts tweaking the situation.
When it starts turning into sort of a Frankenstein story.
Yeah.
Like, which is where I really needed more weirdness. And you know who I would have liked to have seen make this film? A Charlie Kaufman, and not the makers of Little Miss Sunshine, who too often play it safe.
It feels like it does. It kind of feels like I said, Charlie Kaufman directed.
Like they rounded the edges off it, which, and I understand why, because you have to try and play this as a romantic comedy to appeal to general audiences. I just wanted something a little edgier, and it starts to get that with the introduction of Paul Dano's mother in the film, and her froopy artist boyfriend, Antonio Banderas.
And Annette Bening.
Yes, who are fun. And there are good things in this film.
No, I just, for me, like, I think I obviously like this a lot more than you did. I think it was actually, it was brilliant, it was charming. I think it's probably the best romantic comedy of the year. It was, like I said, it's the fun parts where he starts tweaking everything. And it's where he goes, oh, she doesn't like me enough. And basically with his typewriter can control her, make her, you know, do things and have characteristics that she didn't have before, where she speaks fluent French. But when he says, like, you know, I wish she was around me all the time. Well, it's kind of like, it's. Kinda, I mean, the title could almost be careful what you wish for.
Yeah.
Because next thing you know, this girl is not leaving his arm for anything. Like a phone rings, where are you going? I miss you already. You know, he's like, I gotta answer the phone.
Not just credit her for writing it, which is where Zoe Kazan really carries this film.
Mm-hmm.
Because she can go from a fictional creation that's flesh and blood, and then suddenly she's so fictional she doesn't seem real.
Yeah, well, and that's too. I mean, like, this her character has such a range of emotions in this film that she does a brilliant job at it. Mm-hmm. And so I give her a lot of credit for that. And I like Paul Dano in this one.
Yeah.
We may differ on that.
Yeah, I'm not the biggest fan.
And even Steve Coogan shows up, and I liked him. I think the whole cast was great. It really was, I think, one of the best films for me of the year in the comedy, you know, romance genre. But you know, maybe we'll.
Yeah, we're gonna disagree. I really like Zoe Kazan, and I like aspects of it. Including the most accurate depiction of a dog on screen I've seen in years, and I love Annette Bening and Antonio Banderas. Just that sanitized filmmaking from the co-directors sort of took me out of it. It almost makes the film feel like more of a cliched romantic comedy than it should, because it feels so safe when it shouldn't. And I wish I liked Paul Dano more. I'm in about 2.5-star territory for it. I like the promise of it more than what I got out of it. But Zoe Kazan is great, and she's got great things in her future.
Yeah, I think obviously I'm above you. I think I'm giving it 3.5. When I walk out of a film with just a big smile and saying, like, I really enjoyed that. I just kind of want to watch it again, you know? That's how I walked out of this film.
It doesn't happen too often.
No, it was charming beyond belief, in my opinion. So, all right. Well, after this break, we're going to be talking about maybe Jeremy Renner can be charming. And The Bourne Legacy. We'll see what he does.